This great land is the cornerstone of civilization since times immemorial. Layered in its history is the legacy of the Greeks, the Mughals, and the British. The first footprint of civilization is here, the ancient city of Harappa. For centuries, its soil has given birth to contemporary geniuses. Dr. Sir Allama Muhammad Iqbal, Faiz Ahmed Faiz, Dr. Abdul Salam. It has people and politicians. It has history and heritage. Culture and agriculture. Fairs and festivals. It is a province of fabulous folklore. It is the timeless province of Punjab. Punjab is Pakistan's largest province with an area 1.5 times larger than England. Its GDP is $276 billion. Punjab contributes 62% to Pakistan's economy.
This political government has this political will and political sense to provide full support to all these initiatives which can promote public-private partnership, private-private partnership, and also attract investment in those areas which were hitherto totally no-go areas for private sector.
With a total population of 93 million, Punjab is larger in terms of market size than some European and other Asian countries.
I do believe Punjab has very bright prospects. If you really consider, Punjab has 93 million people as a population, and more than half of the people are under 25 years old. So we have a potential of a great sector in that, you know, people who can contribute to the society. Punjab is very, very ideally located. It has huge water resources with the five rivers which are flowing, you know, and a skilled labor force with a reasonably good infrastructure.
One of the fastest growing economies in this region, with Pakistan's GDP growth rate of 8.4% in 2005 and an average growth rate of 7% since 2003, Punjab is one of the most successful transition economies in attracting foreign direct investment.
And when you're a foreign investor like we are, you look at the environment in which you are investing, and you don't just look at 3 to 5 years. You have to look at 25 years, 30 years. And if you look at the population, the number of people living in Punjab, you look also at the industry and the environment here in Punjab, it's really, I would say, a no-brainer that the future potential is there. And that's why we are here. You have an environment with growing people, growing wealth, GDP growth is happening. As I said earlier, well-educated people, people who want to learn, people who are entrepreneurial. So if you have a long-term view and a long-term vision, Punjab is an environment in which you have to invest.
This region has received over $5.2 billion in foreign direct investments in the financial year 2008-09 alone. Over 1,200 multinational firms across all sectors are supported by foreign capital. Punjab is transitioning from a largely agrarian economy to a services economy.
I think Punjab has a lot to offer in terms of infrastructure, in terms of human resources, in terms of access, and in terms of creativity. So there's a lot that we can offer across the board. We have everything. We have all kind of regional and geographic sort of extremities in that sense. So there is a potential. It's also one of the most educated areas. So when you talk about the quality of human resources, it's there. So I think if you put all of that together, there's a huge potential. And if this potential is harnessed through foreign direct investment or through local investment, we will see change.
Some important sectors in Punjab are industry and textile. Punjab accounts for almost 60% of all industrial value addition in Pakistan. Large-scale manufacturing sector constitutes 55% of value addition in the sector. 60% of Pakistan's export comprise of textiles. Punjab contributes to over 70% of Pakistan's cotton production. Energy and power. Consumption increases 8 to 9% per annum. It is expected to reach 21,000 megawatts by 2010. 235 million tons of coal reserves are still available. Agriculture. Punjab is a leading player in agricultural production and contributes 68% to annual food grain production in the country. Over 60% of Pakistan's export earnings are derived from agriculture. Punjab also has the world's largest canal irrigation system. Horticulture. Punjab is the fifth largest mango producer in the world. Citrus, dates, potatoes and onion are among the best quality in the world. Only 10% of the produce is exported.
Punjab provides certain advantages which certainly are better than they would be elsewhere in Pakistan. One is the climate is very conducive. Second is it has an unlimited supply of talent, both with the blue collar worker as well as with the white collar worker. Cities of Punjab like primarily Lahore and Multan and Faisalabad now provide very good educated talent with skills up to master's and even PhD degrees. And these are the people really who help you take your mission forward in industry.
Livestock. Livestock contribution in national GDP is 11.3%, and in the agricultural value addition, its share is around 51.8%. Punjab is the seventh largest milk producer in the world. Pakistan is the world's 12th largest recipient of worker remittances totaling $6.5 billion in financial year 2008-09. Punjab has, among the South Asian economies, one of the best infrastructure and an efficient network of roads connecting all of Punjab and other provinces. Punjab Board of Investment and Trade and its role. Punjab Board of Investment and Trade is Punjab's premier investment promotion agency, linking Punjab to a global network of progressive investors.
The real reason for creating PBIT was that there needed to be a professional interface for government. As you know, government is a very large entity which a lot of people sometimes don't understand and don't know how to navigate that well. So the idea was to create the Punjab Bureau of Investment and Trade to facilitate investment, especially private sector. In Punjab, 9/10 of the employment is generated by the private sector. And therefore, in order to stimulate the private sector and provide a friendly business interface for the government, the Punjab Board of Investment was created. So it provides a one-window operation to all business and facilitates them in their pursuit of economic activity.
The role of PBIT includes one-to-one relationship, reduced time to market, customized financial advisory, world-class research and reports.
I think the biggest advantage we offer people is that we act like the private sector. We understand them, we understand their rationale, we understand their concerns, and we can effectively lobby for them within the government, not only at the provincial level, but also at the federal level. We have very, very close working relationships with our counterparts at the federal level, and we very effectively help and facilitate private investment.
They are creating this linkage between Chamber of Commerce, federal government. It's like almost a one-window operation. Government of Punjab, Agriculture Department, Livestock, they are the one trying to interact with them, providing coordination to potential investors in the province from abroad, Pakistani diaspora in UK, North America, Middle East.
For centuries, explorers have believed in the potential and the promise of Punjab. For centuries, people have reaped rewards for their investments in this great province.
There are vast opportunities in Punjab where whenever there is a low base from where you start, I think this is a place that, I would ask the foreigners to come and invest.
If you are planning to invest, think Punjab. It has been here for centuries. It is here to stay.